ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ भद्रं कर्णेभिश्रुणुयाम देवाः भद्रं पश्येमाक्षभिर्यजत्राः स्थिरैरङ्गैस्तुष्टुवागुंसस्तनुभिः व्यशेम देवहितं यदायुः स्वस्ति न इन्द्रो वृद्धश्रवाः स्वस्ति नः पूषा विश्वभेदाः स्वस्ति नस्तार्क्ष्यो अरिष्टनेमिः स्वस्ति नो बृहस्पतिर्दधातु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंश ऋषिभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरहितः प्रज्ञानगणः प्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः मंत्रा नंबर सेकंड मंत्र यदा लेलायते ह्यर्चिः यदा लेलायते ह्यर्चिः समिद्धे हव्यवाहने समिद्धे हव्यवाहने तदाज्यभागाभंतरेण आहुतिः प्रतिपादयेत् यस्याग्निहोत्रम् अदर्श पौर्णमासम् अचातुर्मास्यम् अनाग्रहणम् अतिथिवर्जितं च अचातुर्मास्यम् अनाग्रहणम् अतिथिवर्जितं च अहुतं वैश्वदेवम् अविधिनाहुतम् आसप्तमांस्तस्य लोकान् हिनस्ति अहुतम् अवैश्वदेवम् अविधिनाहुतम् आसप्तमांस्तस्य लोकान् हिनस्ति We saw yada harchihi lelayate, when the flames are dancing, means fire is well lit. Which fire? Agnihotra fire. When that fire is well lit, tada ajya bhaga vantarena. Ajya bhaga means middle, center. Generally, these rituals are performed facing east. So left and right becomes north and south. So right is south, left is, when you face the east, right becomes south and left becomes north. So in the center, ahuti pratipadayet. In the center, you have to offer ahutis. Two ahutis, oblations, agnaya swaha, somaya swaha, Agnaya Swaha, Prajapataya Swaha. These are discussions in Karma Kanda. Okay. Havya Vahane. We have seen the name of fire. Who Vahanam Karoti, who carries whatever is offered to him and delivers to the respective devatas. to whom it legitimately belongs or to whom it is addressed. In modern language, you can say he's a DHL courier. No, Agni Devta is a DHL courier. He addresses directly. Though he has its own fees, some oblations are meant for Agni Devta, like DHL has its own fees. So, and as I said, this has to be performed. Even when you take to Vanaprastha, they used to perform. This is Agnihotra Karma, which is to be done daily. But then, now teacher says something more. Along with this, certain Naimittik Karmas are to be performed. Certain karmas to be performed on certain time, under certain situation, on certain days. Five karmas are to be performed along with Naimittika Karma. One is Darsha Paurna Masa ritual. Okay? So, Darsha is a karma when it is performed on the new moon day, and Paurna Masa is on the full moon day. Okay? So, yes, Yasya Agni Hotram. Teacher is talking in negative. Whose Agnihotra Karma is not accompanied by these five, six rituals? What is that? Darshamasa, Paurnamasa, Chaturmasya, Atithi Varjitam, Anagrayam. And how it is performed? It should be done as Hutam and Vaishvadevam and Vidina Hutam. Then he gets seven lokas. But if not done either of any one of these things, what are these? New moon day, full moon day, Darsha Paurna Masa. Then the second one is Achaturmasya. Chaturmasya means every fourth month. This is performed throughout the years, means thrice a year it is performed. And if it is not accompanied by Chaturmasyam, then it is called Achaturmasyam. Adarsha Paurnam means not accompanied by this new moon day and full moon day ritual, not accompanied by the quarter, fourth month ritual. Anagrayanam means this is the ritual, it is done in two seasons, in autumn and spring. This is the time when the new crop comes. So that time, this crop is cooked, rice is cooked and especially offered. If it is not done during that time also, it is called Anagrayanam. Then he says, Avaishvadevam, means Vaishvadeva Yagna is also not performed. There are a group of 10 devatas. A special ritual is to be performed, offering to this that particular group of deities. Okay? And this is to be performed before eating, small ritual. Before you eat, you offer this food to fire. And then they eat the food. And Atithi Varjitam Cha. There is a value in our culture, Atithi Devo Bhava. Matru Devo Bhava, Pitru Devo Bhava, Acharya Devo Bhava, and Atithi Devo Bhava. Please understand, Atithi Devo Bhava means not, Matru Devo Bhava means what? Please understand the correct translation. Matru Devo Bhava doesn't mean may mother be God for you. I mean, may look upon mother as God. No. May you be the one who looks upon mother as Devata. May you be the one who looks upon father as Devata. May you be the one who looks upon teacher as Devata. And then Atithi Devo Bhava. This is a unique value of Hindu Dharma, which we should know. In our culture, the food was never sold. And accommodation also was never sold. It is to be shared. If you have a house, I'm telling American jargon, house. not home. Bungalow, that's a British word. In US language, you have to say house. We bought a house. British will say we have apartment. No, flat. We bought a flat. No, it's apartment. Just to develop a new identity, they use specifically new words. Anyway, coming back to that, the house is to be shared. Food is to be shared because it is looked upon as gift of the God. Yagnat bhavati parjanyah, parjanyat anna sambhava. So the grace of Ishvara manifest in the form of food. So in our country, food was never sold, especially cooked food. And the proof is if you search the Sanskrit literature all around, Ramayana and Mahabharata onwards to 15th century, 16th century, Kalidas, Bhatti, etc., never ever you will find a mention of a hotel. During the Vanavasa, Rama, Lakshmana and Sita never went to Khodiyar tea stall in the morning for having a cup of tea, or never went to Bajrang Ghatia house. This is a typical Saurashtra Ghatia house for morning breakfast. And nor Pandavas went to Ganesh tea stall or Umya lodge or something to eat the food. Never. So much so I remember, I was by and large brought up in cities, not big city but small, and then ultimately metros. So I didn't have much of exposure of the village. When I came to Saurashtra in the 80s, I mean 88 or somewhere, I first time came. So by then I started some classes. I used to shuttle between Ahmedabad and Rajkot. Puja Swamiji had started the Salisbury Ashram. So 6 months he used to come to India, and Viditatman used to go there. And I used to take care of his ashram. I shuttled between Rajkot and Ahmedabad for almost 10 years, handling his classes those days, and then coming here, and then to travel in a city in ST buses, 5.5 hours travel, finish the class and travel night here, next day morning your classes in Rajkot, like that. Anyway, so those days I was new, people used to tell me, people, when they go for yatra, you know, they have the padyatra, they walk. There is a value to walk and do pilgrimage, not by car. There is a definition. In Hindi, they say, what is pilgrimage? You book a 5-star hotel and come by flight and go to Dehradun by flight and have an air-conditioned car and comfortable car and go straight to Badrinath in a car, and there is a hotel over there and you get hot water and the bed and the geyser and room heater, and then you have all things, you carry your Coca-Cola tins and fast foods, and then have darshan, and that also paid darshan. You manage some pujaris and get darshan without line and come back. That is not yatra. They say, jisme yatna ho, usi ko yatra kehte. When there is a suffering, then only it becomes yatra. It has to become a tapas. Yatra is not simply going and doing darshanam. Yatra involves tapas. It's a penance. So you find people doing pradakshina of mountains. Even Ayodhya, there is a pradakshina marga. Gokul, there is a marga. And people do satsang, sashtang pradakshina. They do one sashtang namaskar, get up. Then do another and get up. And wherever their hand touched, they draw a line. And then stand there and do another. Like that they do. I have seen people doing pradakshina by just rotating round and round and round on the road. That much value they have. So it should have some yatna in it. Yatna Hindi mein matlab afflictions. You have to take deliberate afflictions with Ishmara Smaranam. by remembering Ishvara. So when they travel from in Saurashtra to Dwarika or Somnath, they go to a village and they look for typical city people, look for some hotel or tea stall. They would not find anything. And sit in the chora, we call it, the central point of the village. They'll just sit and looking, thinking what to do. Some villager will come and ask, where from have you come? Where are you going? Come to home. And they will feed them, give them the stay, and next day they travel. Up to 93-94, government officers have told me, those who are posted in villages, like doctors, and in a small village, they have to go for 3 days, 5 days, 7 days work, some project, village rural development project, and they look for paying guests, you know, who will pay? They will not charge, no. And lightly they say, if you want to pay, go to him. He is weak and help him. But we will not take money. Food was never sold. But this is the gift of Britishers. Annam is to be shared. And that is where Atithi was a day, like a Bhagavan coming to you. We look, may you be the one who looks upon the guest as a devata. And not only food was not sold, but there was no hotel also. So both lodging and boarding were free. Just go there and stay. Even today I see this. Some of the caste, you know, these Kachis, people from the Kutch, Patels and Bhatias, because of the geographical location and situation, it's a desert. There is not much water. Thanks to Narendra Modi that he brought Narmada and they have water. But they migrated out of Kutch for last 3-4 generations. They are in Tamil Nadu and in Calcutta, Bengal and Karnataka, and I visited to them. Some of them are my devotees. So when their children are Tamilians, their face is also black, their hairs are also curly, the boys also like mustaches, the typical of South, you know, South Indian heroes are always with mustaches. And if Bombay wala hero will not find mustaches. They always have mustaches and they are round heroes. So they are like, you cannot distinguish between them and a Tamilian guys. But still, when they build a home, they invariably build on the first floor a big hall, which can have 6, 7, 8 beds, 2 bathrooms, dormitory type, and 2 extra rooms. Well, this is for whom? This is for guests. Modern families require hardly 2-3 bedrooms because 2 plus 2 are there only. I mean, they are only 2 or 3 children. And 2 bedrooms for children and 1 for them, and then 1 is extra and the ground for itself. But first floor they will build. Is a value. Atithi Devo Bhava. Atithi Vratam, Atithya Vratam, Puja Swamiji used to tell his incident. When he was young, one of the villager from his Minjikuti village opened a hotel. And he used to tell that his daughter didn't get a match. They said, the villager said, he's selling food, doing papa. You should not sell. Not only you feed, but feed with respect. And traditionally, the grihastha, the head of the family, is supposed to give a call. He is supposed to go out of the home and look around and shout, is anybody in the village hungry? Any visitor, outsider? Thrice he has to give a call. And if no one turns up, then only he can eat. Otherwise, he should not eat. You don't do that, especially in metros. you will end up becoming one of them seeking food because they will eat all your foods. You start feeding them and you end up without the food. But then in the Saurashtra, there is a value. There are two annakshetras, three in fact. They are 24 by 7 open. So atithi varjitam means one who has not fed the guest and not respectfully not fed the guest. That is the one whose Agnihotra is not accompanied by this and two more things. These are all Naimittikas. You know, Darshamasa Yajna, Paurnamasa Yajna, then Agrayana Yajna, Chaturmasyam Yajna, and then it is Vaishvadeva Yajna, and then without feeding the guest. And how, to what extent one should be careful about any kind of omissions and commissions. Ahutam avidhina ahutam. Ahutam, and he says avidhina ahutam. Ahutam means with a is alparth, not abhavarth. Ahutam means not, it doesn't mean not offered, but something less, something otherwise, some self-compromise. Then again, they say in Gujarati, Bhagavan do bhavna bhukhya budu hale. Bhagavan is hungry of your bhava. So you can give anything, Bhagavan is okay with anything. That doesn't work. You have to do as per the stipulation. And by the way, I would like to tell this, not for any other reason, but to cement your Shraddha in Vedas. When you do as per the stipulation, whatever is to be offered, when is to be offered, how is to be offered, you do that. Phalam is guaranteed. You get the proof of the success of the karma then and there. And this is from the horse's mouth in my case. When we had a temple, Pran Pratishtha, we built this temple and in 2002 we consecrated the temple. That time I made sure whatever Panditji asked for, we got it. I sent people, a couple of persons, sent across India to get some river waters and certain vanaspatis. In Dravya Shuddhihi, each Dravya was so clean and with the clean money also. Not a single rupee in cash for the temple. Everybody, the taxpayers' money I took. I made sure that the people who sat for those vidhi also were very honest to the government and in their life. And the Panditjis also were Shuddha, very pure. They were doing the rituals clearly. He meant it well. And then fortunately all those students who were invited to do, they did it with so much of devotion. This Deepak and Venu were witness to that whole thing. Pratibha and Nalini Ben were also there. Some of them are attending the class now itself. And of course, Kruti's in-laws were there. At the end, even in between, the one day Panditji forgot to do Shayanam of the Bhagavan. Midnight, Bhagavan woke him up. And he came at 12 o'clock and performed the vidhi ritual and then went back. Two such incidents happened during the ritual. Some omissions was left out. And the last day, the vidhi ritual is that you offer a mirror. That is Anjan Shalaka. You open the eyes and Bhagavan looks at mirror. Being a lingam, it was symbolic with a silver stick. Pujya Swamiji did the opening of the eyes and by offering honey, and there is a ritual. And in the hand, Swamiji showed the mirror. the mirror cracked vertically. And same thing we did after 18 years. Again, these all the names that I said, Nipa and Deepak, and then Pankaj Bhai and Varshab and Kruti's in-laws were there. Even I think Alpa and few other Baroda students are also were there across here, Jayendra Bhai, Nipa's parents. After 18 years, when I again did reconsecration, which is supposed to be done by 12 years for any omissions and commissions, you perform the whole ritual again. It cracked in my hands. So, ahutam, hutam means you have to do as per stipulation. And when you do that, result is guaranteed. Some of the Canada students were incidentally were there. Rani was there. I think Saroj also was there. I don't remember that. And our Avani also was there. Avani, Dhirubhai, they all were there. So, vidhina hutam, as per the stipulation. This Agnihotra and all these rituals are to be done as per stipulation throughout the life. Imagine how cumbersome it is. How much commitment one has to have. How much persuasion is warranted. And avidhina hutam means not as per the vidhi. Means when it is told, Ajya Bhaga Vantarana, in the middle, Yada Leela Yate Harchi, when the flames are there, dancing flame, that means it should happen that way. Even in monsoon, it should be like that. And in the beginning or middle of the winter, which is a windy season, it should be like that. Everything you have to adhere to throughout the life, then he gets all one of those seven lokas. Bhuhu, Bhuvaha, Suvaha, Mahaha, Janaha, Tapaha, Satyam. Either of this loka he gets. And if not there, Adarsha Purnamasam, if not done this full moon day and new moon day, Yajna, Chaturmasam, every fourth moon, then on the autumn and the spring ritual is not done, Vaishwadeva is not done, any one of them. And Atithi Varjitam means a guest are not offered, some compromise is done in the material or rituals, or avidhina, you don't adhere to the rituals, you don't adhere to mantras, then you lose any of these lokas. Means ayasa matram karma bhavati, Shankaracharya says. It will not bear the phalam. It's just an effort. That activity is like playing cards. It doesn't make you any wiser. It's a time pass. In fact, whiling away the time, not even a time pass. So, this to gain the karma phala hereafter, what one gets is any of these lokas. But to gain the lokas, all these things have to be adhered to. And as I said, you know, you cannot compromise. When it is said ghee, cow's ghee, you have to have Deshi cow's ghee. When it is said Ganga Jalam, means you have to have Ganga Jalam. And then it gives the phalam. So, and by the way, one more thing also, these are all naimittika karmas to be done on a nimitta, on certain time, certain place, certain situation. But two more nitya karmas are also to be done, which are not mentioned here. One is Sandhyavandanam. You have to perform Gayatri Japa and offer the oblation to sun. So that karma is called Udaka karma. And this is called Agni karma. This fire, this rituals is Agni karma. So daily two karmas, udaka means water, udaka karma and agni karma. And along with this, grihasthi has to do agni hotra, then grihasthi is supposed to perform other five rituals, what they are called rituals in Bhagavad Gita. These are all prayaschitta karma. Of course, whatever is mentioned here, that you have to perform Agnihotra like this, and the flame should be like this, and in all these rituals, there will be some omissions and commissions. Because you will then throughout the life. One day you will be sick, or one day there will be dry woods, you may not be available, or oblation, you may not have the ritual material, etc. So then there are certain prayaschitta karmas mentioned in Shastra regarding this. Omissions and commissions. But these omissions and commissions cannot become daily routine. Now, one more thing they say, this grihastha life involves some himsa. You end up doing some kind of himsa, violence, whether you like it or not. It is like the vast statement, jivo jivasya bhojan. The whole creation being cyclic, there will be some hurt and injury to others. So as an antidote to that, there are five things to be performed daily. That is also nitya karma. Called as panch yagnas. Kuttani, Peshani, Chulli, Udakumbhi, Chaityadi, there are five types of papas mentioned in Shastra according to that type of that time's lifetime. Like pounding the grains, mop, cleaning the floor, and cooking because you burn firewood, etc. In a modern lifestyle, also there is papa. Like you to drive in the evening after sunset on highway or in the city roads, you end up killing those bugs and the flies which come to your dashboard thinking that it's the lamp. So you do some himsa. Any medicine that you take before the clinical trials start, there are trials on the animals. And there are clinical trials also, some people volunteer to suffer. There is always himsa. Some or other will be there. And inadvertently you do it. You step upon those bugs and things like that. You use this mosquito repellents and kill mosquitoes. There is himsa. So as a prashittam panchasu, that is saying panchasunaha grahastaha. The grahasthi is supposed to perform five yajnas. Adhyapanam brahmayagna pitruyagnastu tarpanam homo daivo balir bhauto nru yagno atithi pujana. Brahmayagna, one is pitruyagna, devayagna, bhutyagna and nruyagna. Nruyagna means atithi pujanam, feeding people. Bhutyagna means feeding animals. You see, we city people don't see how the food grains grow. I saw it very late time, but then I discovered. When they plow the field, there is one white bird which walks behind the plow. In Gujarati, they say, Jivda khau baglo. When they plow, the land is topped, is surveyed, and the thing inside comes out. That particular bird keeps on eating those insects. So before you saw, already himsa is done. And having sown the food, you apply fertilizers and pesticides and so much of himsa. So bhutyagna, that is still there in Indian culture. Every village has a bird feeder, village bird feeder. And the oldest person of the home will take food grains and offer it to the bird feeder. They will have a water tank for the birds. Even in city, the new form, like our dancers, used to dance in the temple, but they changed the form, they kept the spirit. They changed, now the dancers dance in an auditorium, but on the stage of the auditorium, they will put some Ganesha or Nataraja, light the lamp and do puja and then start the dance. So convert the auditorium into temple, the platform of the auditorium. So also in the cities I have seen, every street corner there will be some stone structure where they put food for cows and the dogs and the stray animals. That is Bhut Yagna. Guru Yagna, Bhut Yagna, Pitru Yagna. That Shraddha and Tarpanam is to be done for three generations on every Amavasya. Father, father's father, mother, and father's grandparents. Mother and mother's parents and mother's grandparents. Paternal, maternal side, two generations up. Then the parents is to be done. That is Pitru Yagna. Agnihotradi is Deva Yagna. And Brahma Yagna means the body of the knowledge which your parents inherited. One must gain that knowledge and pass on to generation next. That is what it is called Swadhyaya. Swadhyayo Adhyetavyaha. Swadhyaya Pravachana Abhyam Na Pramaditavyam. Deva Pitru Karya Abhyam Na Pramaditavyam. Ityadi mantras are there in Taittiriya Upanishad. So this Yajnas, Panch Yajnas, Brahma Yajna, Pitru Yajna, Deva Yajna, Bhut Yajna, and Nru Yajna, that has to be done. And Agnihotram and Sandhyavandanam to be done. And Darshamasa, Purnamasa, Agrayanamasa, Chaturmasya, Atithi Pujanam, Vidhina Hutam, Avidhina, etc. All to be done. Then the fellow gets these seven lokas. And if not, some omissions and commissions, tasya saptalokan hinasti. He misses all the seva, all the lokas. Okay? And Pujya Swamiji used to say this, all this is to be done with Shraddha. So when we are in difficulties, or in life crisis, we lose Shraddha. So then, that day he may perform Agnihotra, fighting with Bhagavan. You are useless and you are not doing this and I am so good and I have been doing all these years, so many things and like that. And some of the people justify also. Okay, Bhagavan is my father, Bhagavan is my beloved, so I can fight with him, that Bhakti Sampradaya. Why should you fight? You have no right to complain. Better listen to him. He's the almighty Sarvagna Sarvashaktiman. What he does is proper. Just like learn to accept rather than grudging. That fact that you want to fight, that means you have not grown up. Like a small child will fight with a mother. Grown up baby would understand that whatever she is doing for me is good for my health. And would listen and do the things whatever your mother wants me to do. That is Ashraddhaya Hutam. You know this, that Gita says, anything Hutam Dattam Krutam, Ashraddhaya, without Shraddha will not bear fruit. So all this is there. Then you get karma. Please understand. This is, I know this for all of us, at least for all of you. I am exempted having taken sannyasa. Mm-hmm. It is just an academic piece of information. When saptalokas are lost, if all these are not accompanied to Agnihotra, but very Agnihotra is missing, there is a question of satellite karmas. There is no Agnihotra karma. So, but point is, two things you should know. It is not necessary that you must do only that. True. Possible one must do because it's our tradition and Vedas are very powerful, mantras, etc. But then certain puja, certain forms of worship should become our daily routine. Not only puja, but certain rich yajnas like Shraddha Karma, Tarpan Karma to elders, which on every Amavasya or on a Shraddha day we have to do, at least feed guests. If you can't feed in America and Canada, invite me. Guest will come. At least there also people become stingy. No, 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 only Swamiji, you come. Then sometimes I have to tell them, okay, no, no, somebody who will bring me also will be there. Ah, okay, okay, okay. So they are doing a big thing. Anyway, these all things have to be done. We have to hold on to forms. If you hold on to forms, someday the spirit will develop. If you miss the form, the spirit will never come. So some puja, some niyama, that these things I will do it daily, then one should have that kind of niyama, commitment for oneself. Just as you have commitment for your work, you reach on time and you perform, so also one must perform and do the things for one's growth, self-growth, commitment. Anyway, he sort of concludes this discussion by further describing what kind of the flames this, for me also is just an academic because I have not been able to identify. But still, it's there in Upanishad, let us look at it. Mantra number 4. स्फुल काली कराली मनोजवाच काली कराली मनोजवाच सुलोहिताया च सुधूम्रवर्णा सुलोहिताया च सुधूम्रवर्णा स्फुल्लिंगिनी विश्वरुचि च देवी स्फुल्लिंगिनी विश्वरुचि च देवी लेलायमाना इति सप्तजिह्वाः लेलायमाना इति सप्तजिह्वाः काली कराली मनोजवाच सुलोहिताया च सुधूम्रवर्णा स्फुल्लिंगिनी विश्वरुचि च देवी लेलायमाना इति सप्तजिह्वाः. He says there are 7 types of flames, fire flames. One is Kali. Kali, Karali. The Kali, this well-lighted fire, first of all he says, Yatha Sudipta, that earlier first mantra. Kali means the blue flame. Where it is all black, you know, very dark. Kali, Karali means terrible. Manojava, who moves faster than the mind, like a speed of mind, means swifter. Sulohita, Lohita means red. Sulohita means very red, reddish. Sudhumravarna, of the color of the dhumra, the flame itself is of the color of the smoke. Spullingini, spullinga means sparks. Spullingini means so many sparks. Vishwaruchi, you know, which can go everywhere and very effulgent and shining. This kind of 7 flames are types of 7. I have not studied this. and never had a practical with somebody who knew seven. This karmakand is maybe knowing. Pujya Swamiji used to say this, you know, about the seven planes. To us, it may look something ridiculous. What flames have Kali, Karali, Mano, Java, Sulingini, Sudumbravarna, etc. But then he used to say, in the language of the Eskimos, there are so many words, different names for the snow. They live in snow. They are born and grow and live and die in snow. They have different words for the snow. I don't know them, but he used to say often, and sometimes I have heard some of the words in his lecture, but I should have written down. I never thought that I would require this while giving a class on Mundaka Upanishad. So never bothered to write it down. So, but anyway, I have to look for it. So coming back to this, those as modern Eskimos have different words for different types of the snow, and we feel it is same. So also these Vedic rishis, Vedic society, who grew up with fire, you know. There is a shloka in Gita, Sahayagnav praja srushtva purovacha prajapati. Anena prasayvishvidham esha vostvishta kamaduku. The human beings are created with yajna. So you live with fire. In fact, the marriage is for doing some rituals. Patani is not an emotional or some companion in life, professional compatibility, you know. Doctor would like to marry a doctorani. IT fellow will like to marry IT girl because we are compatible professionally. She is for rituals, dharma. Even grammatically, if you see Panini Sutra, the man is called Pati. Pati iti Pati. Pati means one who protects, one who takes care of the home. And patani, the word patni comes from pati. The e-loper takes place and na is added. And the sutra is patyuhu nitya sanyoge ya nitya yagna sanyoge na adesha syat iti patni. The nakara is added to indicate that this person is patni. Is associated with husband for nitya yagna. Patyuhu for husband, pati, nitya yagna sanyoge. One who joins with him for daily yagnyas, with that objective in mind, that person is called from pati to patni. And if we can't do these rituals today, at least the spirit, what Bhagavad Gita teaches us. You know, Bhagavan has done a lot of revolution. This Upanishad Vidya is called Aranya Vidya. It is given in the forest. He brought into Rana, in the battlefield, you know. Aranya Vidya was given in Rana. And the Upanishadic student is Santo, Danto, Bhutva, you know, one who has mastery over mind and mastery over sense organs and virakta and looking for a guru and mumukshu, etc., etc., is a shishya. Here, Bhagavan is a shishya who is no brahmachari, no sannyasi, a pakka grihasthi. And not with one, but two and three wives. And not Santo, Danto, agitated and excited and stressful. There is kranti, revolution, Aranya Vidya. And so he gives a new dimension to this yajna. If we can't have fire rituals, at least the spirit of it. Idanna mama, when you offer the oblation, Gayatri Swaha, Idanna mama. Indraya Swaha, Idanna mama. Varunaya Swaha, प्रजापते स्वाहा इदन्न मम दैट नथिंग बिलोंग्स टू मी आई एम जस्ट द ट्रस्टी ऑफ व्हाट ऑल आई हैव आई पजेस एंड दिस इज मेंट टू शेयर इन अदर वर्ड्स एन एटीट्यूड ऑफ अ कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटर नॉट कंज्यूमर इन स्वामी जी पूज्य स्वामी जी जार्गन Always trying to be, endeavor to be contributor all the time. Trying to be that is called life of, can be called as life of rituals. And these seven flames are there, and all these flames should be there in the middle because you have to offer there. Ajya Bhaga Vantarana. Which is so difficult, you know, how difficult it is. And when one performs this ritual, all these Nitya Naimitya Karmas, then one becomes eligible for Sapta Loka. This earlier I have mentioned, but I would like to repeat in this context. Lokaha means lokyate anubhuyate iti lokaha. These are the fields of experience. Upper fields, upper urdhva lokaha means that those experiences which will result into pleasure and happiness. Sukha anubhava. Adho lokaha. I mean those which would end up in discomfort, displeasure, unhappiness, pain. This will happen, result into happiness and comfort and relaxation. There are the saptalokas indicate each one being higher. Higher is in terms of giving you a deeper and deeper experience of happiness. Profound experience, not deeper, more profound. The Vishaya is profound. Your capacity to enjoy becomes profound. The entire infrastructure over there also becomes profound. Like the roadside tea is available in India on a tea stall. Buy it for 10, 20 rupees and go to a 5-star hotel and get a cup of tea, which may cost you 750 rupees or 500 rupees. So, in between 1-star, 2-star, 3-star, 4-star, 5-star, 7-star. So, the saptalokahas are like those different degrees of pleasures. And subtler and profound pleasure you get, more you go to upper lokas. Urdhva loke, you get more deeper pleasures. More profound and subtler pleasures. Saptalokan hinasti. If it is done with that, or with all these rituals and keeping and lighting of all these seven flames and offering oblation at the right time, proper oblation with proper mantra, proper rich method, etc., then you get this saptaloka. You become eligible for any of these lokas. Point is, how difficult it is to gain sensual pleasures. It looks easy from outside. But as they say, there is no free lunch. The person who has it keeps on paying the price and pays the price also. That is true here also. One may have a big house, one may have a good car, luxurious car, one may have an iPhone 11 coming or 12, whatever, but then you pay through your nose for all this, for house and the car and the taxes and the maintenance and all that. And then even forget about this lokas. The return on your investment is so meager and it is so fickle. If you think more, you think better, I don't go for it. The price that people pay for that some small sukham, it is like I see in the Western world, some people have a boat, private boat, their own boat, private jet and all that. To maintain that jet, they earn so much for, it is exactly like your weekend, you know. To get that leisure on weekend for a few hours or few hours of extra sleep, you have to exert all the 5 days. The return on investment being very little, so that is to ayasa bahulatvat, alpa phalajanakatvat. It gives rise to very little result. Therefore, virakti prapti arthe to create a vairagya from that, all these discussions are. And what does the phalam going to Saptaloka? How does the jivatma goes? What does he achieve on the path, etc.? And what is the nature of phalam? All that is being talked in next few mantras. We'll take the discussion tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadhaya Purnameva Avashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harih Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.